The topic we are going to see is animation in Android. What is animation? Animation is a method of photographing successive drawings, models, or even puppets to create an illusion of movement in the sequence. Because our eyes can only retain an image for approximately 0.1 second. When multiple images appear in a fast succession, the brain blends them into a single moving image. In traditional animation, the pictures are drawn or painted on a transparent celluloid sheets to be photographed. Early cartoons are the examples of this. But today, most animated movies are made with computer-generated imagery or CGI. The four major types of animation that has been evolved all these days are the traditional animation, stop-motion animation, computer animation, and the mechanical animation. When we see about the history of animation, in 1832, when the phonograph was invented by Joseph Plateau, that the first widespread animation device came into place. In 1834, William George Horner created a similar motion picture projector, putting the drawings inside a drum that turned in a circular fashion. The father of American animation is James Stewart Blackton. Though he is a British filmmaker, Blackton created the first animation in America and was one of the first to use the stop motion technique. In 1900, he was credited for creating the first ever animated film called The Enchanted Drawing. Now let's see about the animation that has been incorporated into Android or the mobile application. The animations in Android can add visual cues that notify users about what's going on in your application. They are especially useful when the UI changes states, such as when a new content loads or new actions becomes available. Animations also add a polished look to your application, which gives it a higher quality look and feel. For this purpose, Android includes different kinds of animation APIs. Let's see the different kinds of features for animation or the types of animation available in Android. Animate bitmaps. When a bitmap graphic such as an icon or an illustration is to be animated, the DrawWell animation APIs can be used. Usually, these animations are defined statically with a drawable resource, but it can also be defined at the runtime. For an example, the play button transforming into a pass button when tapped is a nice way to communicate to the user that the two actions are related to one another. Next is the animate UI visibility and the motion. To move or reveal or hide views within a current layout, you can use the property animation system provided by the Android animation package. It is available in Android 3.0 or the API level 11 and higher. These APIs update the properties of your view objects over a period of time and continuously redrawing the views as the properties changes. An example for this type of animation is Next is the physics-based motion. Sometimes animation should apply real-world physics, though they are natural-looking. To provide these behaviors, the Android support library includes physics-based animation APIs that rely on the law of physics to control how your animation occurs. The two common physics-based animation are the spring animation and the fling animation. So this is an example of the physics-based animation. The animations built by with the physics-based animation API, such as the dynamic animation, are mostly driven by force. The change in the target value results in a change in force. The new force applies an existing velocity, which makes a continuous transition to the new target. This process results in more natural-looking animation. Next is the animation in layout changes. On Android 4.4 or API level 19 and higher, you can use the transition framework to create animations when you swap the layout within the current activity or the fragment. All you need to do is specify the starting and the ending layout and what type of animation you want to use. Then the system figures out and executes an animation between the two layouts. So for an example, the user taps an item to see more information, you can replace the layout with the item details. So this is the example. When we see about the basic process to animate between two layouts is as follows. First, create a scene object for both the starting and the ending layout. However, the starting layout scene is often determined automatically from the current layout. Create a transition object to define what type of animation you want to, and call the transitionManager.go function, and the system runs the animation to swap the layouts. And last is the animation between activities. On Android 5.0 and API level 21 and higher, you can also create an animation that transition between your activities. This is based on same transition framework described above to animate layout changes, but it allows you to create animations between layouts in separate activities. Simple animations such as sliding a new activity from the side or fading it in can be applied. But you can also create animations that transition between shared views in each activity. So for an example, when the user taps an item to see more information, you can transition into a new activity with an animation that seamlessly grows that item to fill the screen. So these are the major different kinds of animation that would be incorporated into our mobile app to make it more lively and user friendly. Thank you.